गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, एम आई ऑडिबल? प्रीवियस क्लास वी वर डिस्कसिंग दिस परसेप्ट्रॉन ट्रेनिंग रूल. दिस परसेप्ट्रॉन ट्रेनिंग रूल इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज इन शॉर्ट परसेप्ट्रॉन रूल आल्सो. ओके, so today just I changed this heading so that you can understand better during the preparation for your exam. Just I changed it, or just I added one more word here, that is with update rule, because if you just remember this heading, inside this heading what all the things I have to explain, you will automatically you will remember and you will explain. See, the perceptron training rule actually we are going to explain here, but inside this perceptron rule we are using one more rule, that is nothing but update rule. So indirectly, so we can call this perceptron training rule as a directly update rule also, no problem. Okay, so why? Because here we are going to update the weights, we are going to modify the weights, we are going to change the weights. Okay, so in bracket I have written here, this rule is used to find the weights, right? So already in the previous class I had shown you one equation, right? So this equation I had already shown you. So that is weight is equal to weight, the existing weight, or that presently existing weight or current weight, plus delta of wi, delta wi, that is nothing but modified weight. So how we have to modify this weight? To find out this delta wi, what is this delta wi? It is a new weight. Okay, so how to find out this new weight so that we can add it to our existing weight? So that new weight will be getting with this equation, that is delta wi is equal to eta t minus o into xi. So till this I had completed in previous class, right? So here this delta wi is calculated as in eta into t minus o into xi. Here what is eta? This eta is called as learning rate. So whenever you attend my classes, as I already told, once again I am telling you, you please keep on noting such type of equations and any notations what I explain you. And you should be keep on carefully listening my explanations. Okay, so here eta is a learning rate. Okay, and t is a target output. So o is a perceptron output, and x I is already you know, that is a example. Okay, so in the previous classes only I already told you the perceptron function. So where small letter o is indicated as a perceptron output, it means the output of perceptron, and it will be plus 1 or else minus 1. When it will be plus 1 and when it will be minus 1, already I told you, right? So there x into wi, x into wi, like this is many terms are there. So x is nothing but training example, w is a associated or corresponding or respective weight with that training example xi. So this x and w will be associated or combined there, right? So here t is a target output, o is a perceptron output, and xi is a particular training example. So here in these three terms, in these three terms, any one term becomes zero, what happens? If any one term becomes zero, then what happens? So suppose if eta is zero, or suppose if t minus o is zero, or suppose if xi is zero, so here the entire RHS will be zero, because zero is multiplied with anything is zero only. So it means that delta wi is a zero only. So if you substitute that zero here and you add it, if you add it with this wi, that is existing weight, so again that existing weight will be remains same. It means there will be no any change in the existing weight. It means that it is indirectly so suggesting us there is no need of any updation or change or modification in your weight. So you can keep that weight as it is. Okay, so I hope you are getting. So till this after in previous class we had to discuss it, right? See, so T is a target output. So now in detail I want to explain what is this actually target output. This target output is nothing but the output of one particular training example. The output got from one particular training example is a target output. Okay, so then small letter O is there. O is a output got or received or generated by the perceptron. So this output we are receiving from perceptron. Perceptron is nothing but what here. So whenever I use these words, so clear picture should come in front of your eyes. Perceptron is nothing but it is a neural network only. Okay, so perceptron is a neural network or it is a main part of neural network or it is a heart of neural network, you can say, or directly you can say perceptron is nothing but it is a one type of artificial neural network. So from this artificial neural network, whatever the output we are getting, so that output is nothing but a perceptron output. Okay, so this perceptron output, perceptron, as I already told, it is a neural network. So if you go back to your module 2, so there we had a decision tree, right? So what was the purpose of that decision tree? That purpose of the decision tree was to classify the training example correctly, either as a positive training example or as a negative training example. Similarly, here also the main purpose of this neural network or perceptron is to classify the training examples. Keep these in your mind. Okay, so perceptron's purpose is it has to classify the training examples correctly. So here T is a target output of a particular training example, and O is a perceptron output, and eta is a positive constant value, and it is called as a learning rate. Okay, so here rate means whenever we see this word rate, usually one thing comes in our mind, that is a speed. It is related to speed. In which speed we are learning? We are learning means what here? We are finding the weights or weight vectors. Okay, so here in which speed, whether per second or per minute, how many weights and how many weight vectors you are finding or determining is nothing but learning rate. Okay, so these things you need to remember here. Xi already I told you, that is a training example. Beta is a positive constant which is called as a learning rate, and T is a target output. O is a perceptron output. So now this learning rate is there. Now this is playing a very very vital role or important role in this procedure or method of learning. So because this learning rate, what it is going to do is, so it is going to reduce, it is going to reduce the degree to which this weights are changing. It means that it is going to reduce the number of iterations, the number of modifications, number of changes in each step we are going to do with weights. So this learning rate is trying to reduce those number of changes. Okay, so then usually this learning rate will be very very small value, that is 0.1. So in fact, so sometimes this small value, whatever I told you just now, that is 0.1, sometimes still it can be reduced. Reduced means how it can be reduced? It can be reduced like 0.09, 0.08, 0.07, 0.06, like this gradually it can be keep on decreasing also. And when it will decrease, the answer is whenever you increase the number of adjustments, number of modifications, number of tuning of these weights, weight tuning. Okay, so whenever you you execute that previous equation just now, whatever I told you, so there if any one part or any one term in this equation, if it is zero, then no need of any updation or modification or tuning of weight. So if these any one of these values are not zero, then definitely here we will get one integer, positive integer value. Then that positive integer value will be substituted here and it will be added to our current or present weight, and obviously that previous weight or our existing weight was there, it will be increased definitely, right? So here so if this small value is 0.1, So it can creep on gradually, it can decrease. So whenever we increase the number of weight tuning or weight modifications or weight updating or weight changing, so how many number of times you adjust the weights, gradually in this small value will be keep on decreasing. So then we have to defend something here, we have to justify something here. What is that? Why this update rule is there? Just now I have shown you this update rule. This is called as update rule, right? So this is called as update rule. What we are updating here? We are updating WI. How we are updating? By modifying or by adding some more weight to our existing weight, then we get a new weight. So it is called as a weight update rule. So this update rule, or it can be called as a training rule, like a perceptron rule. Okay. So this perceptron rule, why it should get always a acceptable or successful weight values only? Converge means what? It meets or it gets or it moves towards the successful weight values or valid weight values or acceptable weight values. So before updating our weights, they may be invalid weights. So they were needed some updation, some modifications, some changes. So when we make these changes or modifications or updates, so then these weights will become valid and acceptable weights. And why it is? The reason is, so if you want to consider one scenario or one case, so here suppose one training example is there. That training example is already classified correctly by this perceptron. Okay, just remember. So what is what I am telling here? So the situation is like this. That training example is there, and that training example is correctly classified already as a positive or a negative, whatever it may be. So it is correctly classified as a positive, correctly classified as a negative. So by whom it is classifying? Just now in today's class only, just I told you, it is the responsibility of perceptron to classify this training example. So definitely this perceptron has classified this training example correctly, right? So here it means perceptron means what here? That is a neural network, or it is a hypothesis. In your previous module, in module 2, decision tree was a hypothesis. Similarly, in this module, perceptron or neural network is a hypothesis. So this hypothesis is correctly classifying this training example as a positive or negative. This is the situation or case now. Okay. So when it is, when t minus 0 is 0, sorry, t minus o is 0, it means that, so when that perceptron is when that perceptron is able to classify the training example correctly, means what here? There is no any need of weight updation. Okay. So when it is a no need of a weight updation, definitely in delta WI, any one of the three terms is a zero. Then only we can say that there is no any need of updation. If there is no need of any updation, means what? That perceptron is correctly classifying the training examples now. I hope you are understanding, right? So here, if t minus o is zero, then entire delta WI will be zero. So that there will be no any weights to be updated. Okay. So suppose if the perceptron is giving us the output as minus 1, so it means that the small o value is minus 1, and this target output is plus 1. So then what happens? So t is 1 here, and minus is minus only, and o value is minus 1, because perceptron output is how much? Minus 1. So 1 minus of minus 1, that is will be 1 plus 1. So then this t minus o will be 2. So 2 into xi into eta. So there will be some positive value for us, and that value is nothing but it is a delta WI value. That delta WI value we have to substitute in the weight update rule. So then we will definitely update the rule, or we add some weight to our existing weight, then that weight will be modified or adjusted or changed or fine-tuned, right? So these are the things. So suppose if this O is minus 1 and T is 1, then only it is a problem. Which problem? We must update the rule. Sorry, we have to update the weight, right? See, so suppose here instead of minus 1, now it is our job to make this perceptron to give the output as a plus 1 instead of minus 1. Okay, so earlier it was giving us minus 1, now it is our job to make this perceptron to give an output as a plus 1 instead of minus 1. So then what happens? So to do this, so these weights must be altered. It means weights should be updated or modified or changed to increase the value of this one, w into x, that is w vector into x vector. So I hope you remember what is this w and x. It is equal to small o. If you remember, you go back and you just see the previous equations. So that is nothing but it is a perceptron rule, it is, or perceptron function. So because small o is equal to, so w vector into x vector already we have written there, right? So here to increase this value of a w vector into x vector, we have to alter, we have to modify these weights. So for example, if this example xi, so just now I told you xi is nothing but a particular example from the set of examples. Okay, it is not like there is only single example. There are multiple number of examples will be there. Because of that only we are calling it as xi. It may be x0, x1, x2, like this. So suppose any particular example is greater than 0, its value is greater than 0, so then this increasing this wi, increasing this wi will make the perceptron to correctly classify this example. So which example? This example only, xi is example, right? So if it is greater than 0 means if it is a positive value. In our previous equation, whatever we have seen just now, in the delta I and the w eta t minus o into the xi, there if xi is greater than 0, okay, or else if you go back and you consider our first most equation of this module, that is o equal to w0 plus w1 x1 plus w2 x2 plus w3 x3 there. So if any x is greater than 0, then increasing that wi also, what it is going to do? It is going to help this perceptron. It is going to make this perceptron to classify the example correctly as a positive or negative. So the main thing is here, the x values should be always positive values. Keep these clues. Some tricks I am telling you, tips I am telling you, okay? So for training example, values will be, should be 0, greater than 0, it means they should be positive values. If they are positive, definitely we have to increase the value of WR, its associated weight also we have to increase, okay? So always these will be pairs only, right? These will be in association, these will be in a combination. So if XI is a positive value, definitely WI value also should be increased, okay? So what this increase will do? This increase of this wi will make our perceptron, or it will help our perceptron to classify this training example correctly. Okay, so note that this our training rule, whatever just now we have seen, it will increase the wi in this case, definitely, because t minus o is a positive value. Suppose if t minus o is a positive, eta is also positive, and xi also positive. Okay, so if all three terms in our training rule or our update rule, if all these three terms are positive, it means all are greater than 0, then our training rule will increase the value of wi definitely, right? So if it is 0, then what happens? If it is 0, then there is no any need of weight updation, right? So here, for example, if xi is 0.8, which is a positive value, which is greater than 0, and eta is also 0.1, as you know, I told you, it should be always a small value or minimum value. And of course, it will keep on decrease if the number of weights, weight tuning iterations or weight modifications or weight adjustments will be more, okay? So number of weight adjusts are more, then this eta will be still, it will become lesser values, or it will be decreased. And t is 1 here and o is a minus 1 here. So then what happens into our delta wi? Delta wi will be eta into t minus o into xi, right? So eta is 0.1, which is a small value, and t is a 1, that is nothing but target output is 1 plus 1, and here minus is minus only, then the O value is minus 1 here. In this case, what happens? So here 1 minus of minus 1 is a plus, so 1 plus 1 will be 2, 2 into 0.1 into 0.8, then we will get 0.16. What is this 0.16? This 0.16 is nothing but a delta Wi. Then you substitute this 0.16 in that formula, then definitely we will add this 0.16 to our existing weight, then Wi will be, again, it will be increased, right? So indirectly what we are doing here, we are increasing the Wi, right? So if you increase the Wi, it means that you are making your perceptron so much perfect. It means that you are making your perceptron or your neural network to classify the training examples correctly. I hope you are understanding it, right? So otherwise what happens, if this t is minus 1 and O is plus 1, then this Wi, that is weights which are associated with this xi value, that xi is nothing but what here, that is training example xi. So these will be, weights will be decreased instead of decreasing. Why? Because if you apply these, if you substitute these values here, what happens? So eta is already 0.1, okay, and t is minus 1, O is 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, then it will be minus 2. Minus 2 means it is a negative value. So if this is a negative value, then weights will not be increased, weights will be decreased. So just remember, so whenever in this equation delta Wi, if any one term is 0, no weight updation is required, okay? If these any one of these terms or all these terms are positive, then the weight updation is required. And how it is required? We have to increase the value of Wi. We have to increase the value of Wi, okay? So that is nothing but you are making a perceptron to classify your training examples correctly. You are making your perceptron perfect, okay? And if these values, any one of these three values is negative, so then the weight value will be not increased, the weight value will be decreased. So if weight value is decreased, then what happens? Perceptron is not able to classify our training examples correctly. So the only thing is the Wi should be always either increased or else all three terms in this equation should be zero for us, right? Only these things. So if it is zero, then it is very, very, very fine. So if these are not zero, it means these all three values are positive values, then only it will be tension for us to update the weights. And how we have to update the weights? So that W value should be increased instead of decreasing. And of course, it will not decrease because all three terms are positive only. If any one term is negative here, then weight will be decreased and perceptron is not able to classify our training example correctly. Okay. So in fact, this whatever the procedure just now I told you, so to find out or to update, to finding the weights and updating these weights, this procedure is going to give us a guarantee, or it is going to prove us that it converges, or it will meet, or it will get to a valid and successful or acceptable weight vector. Okay, so this whatever procedure just now I discussed with you, so this procedure will give us guarantee that. So this procedure will give us definitely one acceptable weight vector or a successful weight vector or valid weight vector. And what this successful weight vector is going to do? Okay, so this weight vector is going to classify, or it means that it is making our perceptron to classify our training examples correctly. So because of that only we call these weights as a acceptable weights, valid weights, successful weights. Okay, the only thing is to this procedure whatever just now I discussed, so what we have to provide as an input to this procedure, the two conditions are here. make our perceptron to classify our training examples correctly, or to get the successful weight vector, so we have to provide the training examples in such a way that those training examples should be linearly separable. Linearly separable means, in previous classes I have shown you two diagrams, A and B, that is graphs, right? So there, what happened? See here, A and B. Here plus 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 are there. What are these plus plus plus? So these are nothing but training examples, positive training examples, and these are negative training examples. Here we can make a clear separation between these training examples. Okay. So if this is possible, then we can say that training examples are linearly separable, right? So if it is in such type of cases, as shown in this figure B, so these training examples are non-separable, linearly non-separable training examples. Okay, so these training examples cannot be made separate, separated with one straight line here. Okay, so that is the meaning here. So the only condition to make our perceptron to classify training examples correctly is we have to provide some input to this perceptron. That is nothing but we have to give our training examples, particularly which training examples. So those training examples should be linearly separable. And also second condition is our eta value should be small enough, that is sufficiently enough. If eta value is sufficiently small, means what here? So it means that whenever the number of weight updations or changes are more, the number of weight adjustments are more, at that time this eta value will keep on gradually decreasing, right? So this sufficiently small, this eta should be sufficiently small, means number of weight tuning should be increased. If number of weight tuning is increased, or the number of weight tuning or number of adjustments are large, then definitely this eta will be keep on gradually decreasing. And then what happens? So this is continuously keep on decreasing from 0.1, right? So how it is decreasing? 0.9, 0.8, sorry, 0.09, 0.08, 0.07, 0.06, 0.05, 0.04, 0.03, 0.02, 0.01. Then what happens? Then it becomes 0.00, right? So if this eta itself is a zero, then entire RHS of this equation delta Wi will be zero. Then the delta Wi value will be also zero. If delta Wi value is zero, means what here? There is no any requirement of weight updation. Okay, so that is very, very nice for us now. So there is no any tension for us to update the weight. So because of that only, the number of weight updates should be more, so that this eta value should be less, then weight updation requirement will be no. Okay, this is the funda behind this training rule, that is a perceptron training rule. So if this training examples or training data are not linearly separable, or they are linearly non-separable, then this convergence is not a guarantee for us. Now this procedure is giving us some guarantee. It will definitely give us the successful weights, so that perceptron will be successfully or correctly classify our training examples, right? Now if these training examples are not linearly separable, then this perceptron is not able to identify or classify our training examples correctly as a positive or negative. It can make a mistake. By mistake, it can tell the negative training example as a positive and a positive training example as a negative. Okay, so this is the perceptron training rule. Okay, so let us go to next rule. Similarly, here one more heading I have modified and I have given to you so that you can write on your own thing here. So that second training rule is a delta rule. Okay, and here main important thing what we are using, because in previous what we did in a perceptron rule, we have used update rule, updation rule. So because of that only, in heading only I told you, so perceptron training rule with update rule. Okay, and in bracket also I had given there to find out the weights. But here also we are going to find out the weights in delta rule. So along with this delta rule, what we are doing here is we are going to use gradient descent. Okay, so because of that only in heading only I have given. You remember this technical word or mathematical word or algebraic word that is gradient descent. Okay, so just remember the meaning of gradient. Gradient is nothing but direction. Descent is nothing but downward direction. Okay, so downwards. So here we are keep on searching these hypotheses or our weights towards a downward direction. So because of that only this term is used here, that is a gradient descent. One second. Okay, what about others? Screen is visible, eh? Visible, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Aishwarya, maybe it may be a network issue with your network. You please try again.
No, sir, now it is visible.
Okay, fine. Okay, see, this delta rule is going to overcome the disadvantage of our previous rule, that is a perceptron training rule. So what was the disadvantage or limitation of that rule? First we have to understand. Just now I told, so that perceptron training rule works best only when the training examples are linearly separable, right? So, but this delta rule is so much powerful than that previous rule, because this delta rule is going to make that perceptron to classify the training examples not correctly or perfectly, at least approximately. It is going to try, or it is going to try its level best to classify the training examples correctly, even though the training examples are not linearly separable. Okay, so this is the main important thing or importance of this delta rule. So it is going to overcome the disadvantage or limitation of perceptron rule. So what was the perceptron rule's disadvantage? The training examples should be linearly separable there. Then only it can make the perceptron to classify the training examples correctly. But here, even though training examples are not linearly separable, our perceptron can identify them as a positive or negative, not 100%, but at least 99%. Okay, so this is what this delta rule is going to do with the help of this gradient descent method. Okay, so here clearly I have given in this third point that if this training examples are not linearly separable, this delta rule is going to converge toward a best fit approximation to this target concept or weight vector. Okay, the main key idea behind this delta rule is to use this gradient descent. Okay, what it is using? It is using this gradient descent. So why it is using this gradient descent? To search the hypothesis space. So you can call this delta rule as a search rule also, because in previous modules so many times I told you we have to search hypothesis in the hypothesis space capital H, right? So in this module also we are going to search hypothesis in the hypothesis space, but here hypothesis is nothing but a perceptron or a neural network in a space of neural networks. It means a set of infinite set of neural networks. There we are going to find out some neural networks or perceptrons. And instead of calling them as a artificial neural network or perceptron, so if you want to use a most sophisticated word and particular or specific word, then you can use this word, weight vectors. Because here hypothesis is full of weight vectors, there we are going to find out some weights which are consistent with our training examples. Okay, so it means that here only I have used that word. Best fit means what here? These weights are best fit our training examples is nothing but they are best fit is nothing but they are consistent with our training example. Okay, so we are interested in the weights which are consistent with our training examples, and only we will search, we will find only those weight vectors in the hypothesis space. And who is going to search here? With which method we are searching this one? With the method of gradient descent. Okay, so this rule is very, very important, because this gradient rule is playing a vital role once again, because it is going to give us one fundamental foundation for this back propagation algorithm. As I already told in previous class, in this module we are going to study one important algorithm, that is back propagation algorithm. So this gradient descent is going to give some basic foundation or basis for this back propagation algorithm. So which can learn networks. So see these words beautifully that author has given. Learn means what here? Find out the networks, search the networks, construct the networks. And networks are nothing but which networks here? Of course, they are artificial neural networks, so which is nothing but the perceptron, which is nothing but the weight vector. Okay, so in many interconnected units, is nothing but if you just bring that artificial neural network diagram in front of your eyes, you will get understand this. So that is, we are going to learn the networks. How that network should be? That network should be containing so many units, and those units should be interconnected. Okay, so it means that indirectly this back propagation algorithm is going to give us one artificial neural network from n number of artificial neural network with the search method, that is gradient descent. So like previous module, this decision tree. So from where we got that decision tree? There also we have used one very important algorithm, that is ID3 algorithm, right? So here also this back propagation algorithm is going to give us artificial neural network with the layers, input layer, output layer, and hidden layer, with some units which are connected to each others. Okay, so here it is very, very important, because gradient descent can serve the, or it is providing us basis for learning or finding the algorithms that must search through this hypothesis space. This hypothesis space are containing many different types of continuously parameterized hypothesis. Don't worry about these words, just if you remember this also, it is sufficient. So hypothesis space definitely contains hypothesis. In our module, what is the hypothesis? Hypothesis is nothing but what here? Weight vectors. Okay, so, or you can say artificial neural network also, no problem. Or you can say perceptron also, no problem. Okay, so here the gradient descent is used in this delta rule. So to understand this delta rule, first we should understand the unthresholded perceptron. This unthresholded perceptron word is important, just remember this one. Unthresholded perceptron is nothing but, if you remember our previous perceptron function or equation, I had written there small letter O is equal to plus 1 or minus 1. When we get plus 1, if W0 plus W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X3 is greater than 0. There I used one word, that is threshold. That W0 is called as a threshold. Okay, so this, if this perceptron is not containing that W0, okay, that first term, then it is called as unthresholded perceptron. Threshold means what here? Just one cutoff value. Just remember, cutoff value. If the perceptron is not considering that cutoff value, then it is called as unthresholded perceptron. Okay, so first we should understand this unthresholded perceptron before going to understand this delta training rule. And this unthreshold perceptron is also called as linear unit. Okay, linear unit for which this output O is given by O of X. It means what? Perceptron output over the training examples X. Vector X is what? Training examples. So equal to W into X. to just remember, and you just write down this equation. Whenever I tell these equations, you keep on writing in your class notes. Okay, so this equation 3.1, remember, in future we may need this one. Okay, so this this linear unit meaning also I have given here in this second point of this slide. Linear unit means here I use this word, right? Linear unit means what here? This is nothing but this is a first stage of perceptron without threshold, right? So this is a first stage of perceptron without threshold. If you bring that perceptron diagram in front of you, or artificial neural network in front of you, that the first stage means what here? The first stage is nothing but the input layer which is receiving the inputs. Okay, so there in input layer so many units are there, those all units are receiving some inputs. Those inputs are not receiving threshold, so that is nothing but unthresholded perceptron or unthresholded neural network, and it is a linear unit. Okay, linear unit, it means that it is not receiving any cutoff value. So here this is the first stage of that perceptron without a threshold, is called as a linear unit. So to get this weight learning rule, okay, or to weight searching rule or weight finding rule, okay, to get this weight searching rule for linear units, so first we have to mention, or we have to specify one more term is here, that is called as a training error. Okay, it means that before going to learn this delta training rule, first we should understand unthresholded perceptron or linear unit. And to get this weight learning rule or delta rule, we should first understand this training error. Training error means what? Error of hypothesis. Hypothesis means what here? Weight vector. So with respect to these training examples, it means that indirectly the author is telling that there may be some noise, there may be some error in these training examples, there may be some errors in weights. Those errors, so first we have to calculate. Okay, so then it will be easy for us to understand this delta rule. Okay, so there are so many methods are there to find out or to define this error. How to find out this error? Here one more important equation I have written at the bottom of this slide, that is capital E is representing an error. Error, where is the error? Error is in weights, that is nothing but weight vector. It means a set of weight vectors. Okay, so error is in the weight vector. And what is this error? How to find out this error? It is simply previously whatever the equation you have used, you know, that is T minus O, somewhere you have used this term T minus O, same thing, nothing is new here. Okay, so just we have added some masala to that equation, that's all. What are those masalas here? So this error is nothing but it is a half of, you just observe, you just keep on listening to me carefully. This error is nothing but it is a half of sum of all those outputs which are with respect to these training examples. Capital D is a set of training examples, a small d is a particular training example which is belonging to this set of training examples, right? So here the sum of all these differences which are present in these all training examples, d d d d, okay, so these differences, which differences? T d minus O d, it means T, already I told you it is a target output, O is a perceptron output for particular training example small d. Okay, so like this for each and every training example, if you calculate this difference, what is the difference between target output and perceptron output, and then if you make its square, then you will get the error. So once again I repeat, this error is nothing but half of sum of square of difference between target output and perceptron output. That's all. Make this equation as 3.2 and keep it in your class notes. Okay, so in within 5 minutes this class will end. So let me to take attendance and then let me to continue in the next class. So before going to next class, because in next class we are going to study DAG propagation algorithm. Before that, we are going to see this delta training rule. So you revise these all things, whatever I had explained today, so that you can catch all the concepts easily in the next class. Okay. See, just answer your attendance. Sridhar?
Yes, sir.
Aishwarya?
Present, sir.
Akshata?
Yes, sir.
Aniket?
Yes, sir.
Pratibha? Saurav?
Yes, sir.
Ankita Patil? Ankita Rupale?
Present, sir.
Geeta? Jyoti?
Present, sir.
Kaveri?
Yes, sir.
Kavita?
Yes, sir.
Komal?
Yes, sir.
Mahadevi?
Present, sir.
Netra? Priyanka?
Present, sir.
Rohini?
Present, sir.
Sakshi?
Present, sir.
Sanket?
Present, sir.
Shruti? Shweta? Soumya?
Yes, sir.
Sujata? Vidyashri? Vishwajit?
Yes, sir.
Mayuri? Shruti Patil?
Yes, sir.
Sneham?
Yes, sir.
Mayuri is present, huh? Mayuri?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you can leave the meeting.